As a painter paints into each work a portion of himself, so God has chosen to reveal himself to man through the things he has created. In our search to find God and know him more intimately, we need only to unfold creation and behold our God. God created every winged bird according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. The golden eagle is the subject of many of the prophets. A native to the Middle Eastern countries, the prophets wrote about these birds of prey with great admiration, often comparing the golden eagle to some godly characteristic.
Those who wait upon the Lord will renew their strength. They will mount up with wings as eagles.
The Lord will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you shall trust. His truth and his faithfulness are a shield unto you. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who forgives your sins and heals all your diseases, who redeems your life, who beautifies and crowns you with loving kindness and mercy, who satisfies your mouth with good so that your youth is restored like the eagles.
The prophet Moses wrote of God's love for his people, comparing it to the eagle's care of their young.
The Lord found his people in a desert land. He encircled them. He cared for them. Like an eagle that stirs up its nest and hovers over its young, he spread his wings and caught them. He carried them on his pinions.
Over and over again, the prophets wrote of God's parental love for mankind in terms of the eagle. There are many things we can learn about God from observing this, the king of birds. And a great many things we can learn about ourselves. Appearing on coins, emblems, flags, and seals of all kinds, the eagle has for centuries been held in the highest esteem by man. Not beating his wings to stay aloft, the eagle simply rides the wind, using its currents to suspend himself. However, the beauty of this story is knowing how the eagle comes to possess this remarkable ability. At the age of about 10 weeks, the mother eagle flies into the nest and nudges one of her young over the edge. Obviously a frightening experience. The eaglet frantically attempts to hold himself up, but has neither the strength nor the wisdom. Seeing the ground approaching, the eaglet senses a feeling of total and utter helplessness. But suddenly, he is whisked up by his father, who has been watching the entire saga all along. This exercise will be repeated over and over again until the eaglet gains the strength and wisdom he needs to fly on his own. These flight lessons so typify God's dealing with us. He seems to allow disastrous situations to come upon us only to deliver us in our most desperate moment. Perhaps our tragedies are merely classrooms where God is teaching us to soar, loving us and watching over us as the eagles watch over, nurture, and train their beloved young. This is but one of the beautiful characteristics of God that is revealed through the story of the eagle. And it is enough to offer us the faith we need to know that God is working in and around us to make us into eagle Christians. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will abide in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say to the Lord, my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. For it is he who delivers you from the snare of the trapper and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you may seek refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and bulwark. You will not be afraid of the terror by night or of the arrow that flies by day. Then I saw a solitary eagle flying in mid-heaven.